It has all the makings of a courtroom drama. Tough defense attorney, a fierce prosecutor, and shrewd witnesses. But this isn't a primetime television show. It's PSJA North High School's mock trial team preparing for their first state competition. Established in 1979 by the Dallas Bar Association, the mock trial program gives students an insider's view of our judicial program. High school teams compete against each other in trying a court case in a simulated courtroom environment.
We have three students that play the attorneys. Now they're going to play, if it's a civil case, they're going to play the plaintiff and the defense. If it is a criminal case, the prosecution and the defense. Then we have six separate witnesses, three for each side. And we also have a timekeeper, then our research team.
As attorneys and as a research team and as witnesses as well, we really dissect the case. We make sure that we can read every single person's statement to see, you know, what is the actual story about or who's telling the truth, who's lying. And then from there, we're able to dissect and create direct examinations, cross-examinations, which is questions where we question the opposing team. We're able to come up with opening statements, which basically tells the story, and closing statements, which basically proves whether or not the witness on trial is guilty or not guilty.
The team at PSJA North High School includes 13 students from all grade levels. Senior Julio Gonzalez Jr., Cynthia Gutierrez, Cesar Becerra, Selena Medina, and Karen De Los Reyes. Junior Valerie Corona, sophomores Andrea Garza, Gabriela Carrillo, Alondra Garza, Elizabeth De Los Reyes, Kitzia Rivera, Ashley Aguilar, and freshman Megan Ledesma. Even though the PSJA North team is fairly new, by working together, the students and their advisors have built a solid mock trial team. Attorney, witness, researcher, everyone plays a critical part in the outcome of the trial.
They need to do the research. They need to know the legal terms. With this particular case, it was aggravated robbery, where they had to actually figure out exactly what that entails. They need to know the rules and the objections, how to respond with certain objections, how to proceed with certain objections, when to actually object, when it's suitable to object.
I play Arian Wohlbarger. I'm the defense witness. I'm the one being charged with aggravated robbery. It's very intimidating at first, but once you know your character and you get up on that stand, it's really fun. And you should know your case, back, forth, left, right, doesn't matter. You have fun being a witness.
The team made history recently and qualified for the state competition in Dallas, taking place on March 7th through the 9th, after coming in second place at the Region 1 competition. Freshman Megan Ledesma was awarded Best Witness, and senior Julio Gonzalez was awarded Best Advocate.
This has been an endeavor of love from myself and Coach Cepeda. And watching these kids grow, especially when you have like one of our seniors who we've seen grow as a little boy, freshman, you know, didn't even fit in his suit. Suit was big for him. And seeing that, you know, the man that he's become now and the love that he has for the law, that's the best experience that a teacher could have.
Being able to stand up in a crowd and really give your opinion and give your point and being able to, you know, prove that you're right and stand up for what you really believe in. Also being able to interact and work with other people. You know, we're working with 10 other people to pretend to find someone guilty or not guilty, and it's just being able to be on the same page and being able to work with freshmen, sophomores, juniors, teachers, and really be in a professional setting as a high school student, and it's a really, you know, learning experience.
It's a learning experience that is teaching these young students essential skills like public speaking and critical thinking, skills that will prepare them for careers in law or any other profession they choose to pursue.
You get to learn how to control yourself in intense situations, especially unpredictable ones, and it teaches you a lot.
They learn definitely how to work with different individuals. We've got a pretty big array of kids that are involved in all sorts of different things, so they learn how to work with each other, even if they wouldn't necessarily rub elbows in any other type of setting. They learn how to deal with certain types of situations when somebody's coming at them aggressively, how to stay calm, how to answer appropriately. They learn simple things like basic courtroom etiquette, questioning, you know, how to look at something in a more constructive manner, how to deconstruct texts. I mean, it pretty much covers every area of curriculum.
They encourage other students to get involved in mock trial for an exciting opportunity. Each year, more than 150 schools across the state and about 2,000 students participate. Scholarships are awarded to the top performing teams and students. There are no objections to the fact that the PSJA North High School mock trial team has what it takes to succeed at state. The final champion team in Dallas will represent the state of Texas at the national tournament held in May. Best of luck and congratulations to the PSJA North High School mock trial team.